In lecturer will say, okay, but I believe from what I read, I quote from Plutarchus, I quote from Heraclitus, this how things were in the book, in that book, at that page, he said this. And we have a bibliography attached, a great bibliography, in order to support his view, and he will be more discussing, more open to discuss about what he supports. Sulfur will say, that's how things are. Okay. So, he is very intellectual and very psoric in his thinking. Psoric, intellectual, coward. Let's talk about coward. We have all said, already said some things, but it's important to understand it. I again say that his physical condition, his body is not so is not psychotic and strong, it is psoric. So, if this is not his strong point, and if his mind is a strong point, he becomes very intellectual. So, he is coward when it comes to physical fight. But he is not very much coward when it comes to intellectual fighting, because he has read a lot of books, he has a good thinking, a good memory, and being thorough, he knows many things. And since he knows many things, and he is good at lecturing and conversation, he's not so much a coward when it comes to intellectual fighting, but he will be kind and gentle, and he wants to discuss it. He has good arguments, but if he tries to do an intellectual conversation with a psychotic type, a Medorinum type, and the Medorinum type individual gets insulted and things are going towards physical fighting, then he will back off. The Lycopodium individual will back off because he is coward as to physical fighting. The same cowardness and shyness, psoric thing, psoric shyness, when it comes to the girl, to girls or to boys, if you are a Lycopodium female individual. This is a very strong field about Lycopodium. Relations, that is mostly girls, and sex. And of course, family. This is a very strong field and characteristic field of Lycopodium. From the moment he is a boy, and again, as years go by, a teenager, he has already the rumor of a good student and a good boy. But he is he cannot get the girl as Medorinum gets it by being strong physically and a dynamic personality. He tries to get the girl by being intellectual, a good boy, a good student, a kind person, a good friend. And that's how he tries to get the girl. But he's shy. He's very much afraid of rejection. not so much for the image towards him, for the image towards others. He's so much afraid that if a girl says no, then she will go to other girls and to other boys and says, he proposed me and I said no. And he will be ridiculed. His image will broke to 1,000 pieces. It's a psoric image. So he likes that girl. He doesn't have any problem going and talking to that girl and tries to talk about civilized things and things that he has read about, and being very polite, very gentle, very supportive, and that's how he tries to get the girl. But if he has to do with a psoric girl, there's no problem. If he has to do with a psychotic girl, then if he doesn't grasp her and kiss her and be dynamic, a dude, the psychotic girl says, back off. He is not a man. He is not a strong guy. How can I go out with him? He doesn't drink much. He doesn't have a good motorbike. He isn't strong. He isn't dynamic. And he isn't strong and good at sex. If the girl is syphilitic, then we may have two kinds of behavior. If it is a syphilitic girl and wants someone strong and smart and equal and dynamic, he will say, okay. If he is a syphilitic person and has the same point of view, but he wants to manipulate this psoric individual, he will manipulate like a body and do it as she wants to do. She will have a fun. She will have someone to manipulate and create her team. So if you, most of the times, if you have a Valeriana syphilitic individual girl, she may choose to have a relation, an affair, with a Lycopodium psoric individual, or with a Sulfur psoric individual, or with a Phosphorus psoric and the good boy, Phosphorus individual, with a psoric individual, a psoric boy, because she can manipulate this boy and will not be afraid that he will go cheating on her. She will plan their life, he will go along with her, and she will have the upper hand with no problems. But then sometime on, Valeriana in girls feel bored with such an individual that she can manipulate. If civilized persons can easily manipulate a psoric person, but they don't have much of esteem about a psoric person that they can manipulate. So they get bored with him. They don't appreciate a person that they can manipulate, a psoric person. So you see, how important are the constitutional influences on a person and how much they define his love, field, his sexual field, his family field. Let's go on to sex. Like a lycopodium, a mentorinum individual, as we have described it, is the one that is strong physically as concerns sex, but superficial as concerns emotions. He is the womanizer, the heartbreaker, and he can do it very well. But he is not for a stable family. He is the one-night stand. While lycopodium is the person, the psoric person, and that's why he is not very strong physically as concerns sex. Be careful. There's a strange thing about lycopodium as concerns sex. He, being intellectual, he has many thoughts about sexual relations and sex. He wants to have a scenario, a strange and well-defined scenario, in order to get high sexually. He may think that he is the teacher, the very civilized teacher. He's about 35 years old, a great teacher, and then there are these 18 years old students of his that are very young and very innocent, and he gets romantic and he sees that they will be fond of him and like him, and then they will push things and he will accept their proposal, and they will have a romantic relation and a romantic sex, which is not going to be the sex, come here, undress, we will fuck the mentorinum individual. He will have these caress, he will say good words, polite words, compliments, they will go to dinner, they will have their whole romantic package. And then after some hours, they may go to bed, or the next rendezvous they will go to bed, and he will be gentle and polite, and he will be the one that will care very much about having an orgasm at the same time, or first he will push his partner, his female partner, to have an orgasm, and then he will have his orgasm too. He is so anxious about pleasing his partner, so anxious, because if he doesn't please his partner, and his partner is a psychotic person or a syphilitic, and will become rude and say, "You are not a man. I don't have an orgasm with you." He will so much be afraid about losing his image towards others. He is very much afraid that she will go to other girls and boys and say, "He's not a man. He doesn't know how to please a woman." So most of the times he tries hard to please his partner, and if he is very anxious and this is their first sexual intercourse, he tries to postpone his orgasm in order to have his partner first have an orgasm. Postponing, then he may have early ejaculation. And this is a very frequent thing about Lycobodium individuals. They easily have early ejaculations, or he may not be able to have an erection, or he may have an erection that is not so hard. So he has a sexual lust, an intellectual sexual lust. He has many thoughts, and he is a very visual guy. He likes to see women. Even if he has a relation, he's the guy that will stare at women, at their boobs, at their ass, at their whole picture, and he makes stories and scenario inside of him. He has a very intellectual kind of lust, creating scenario, how could things be. And being a visual guy, of course, if he has a relation with a Valeriana girl, she is jealous, and she all the time looks if he looks at other women. So he tries to hide it, being a coward. He's a visual guy, that's why he tends toward being a guy that watches porn films very much, but those blue films, blue porn films, that have intellectuality, that have a scenario, that it's not from the beginning to the end a fuck. He likes romantic story, sexual porn. He likes intellectual porn. He likes porn that has a gradual story. From the beginning, they go to dinner, they have food, they look at each other, they grasp their hands, they hold hands, they give a kiss, and then things go to sex gradually. And they are both pleased. He cares too much about his partner. That's the psoric coward relation of Lycobodium with sex and affairs. And if Lycobodium patients often go to the homeopathic doctor or to the sexologist complaining about early ejaculation or not a hard erection. If he has an early ejaculation for the first time, then he gets so anxious that there is a great possibility that next time he will again have another one, and then he's got a chronic problem. Many times he will prefer masturbation because he doesn't have the anxiety to please the partner. From the early teenage, Lycobodium has a great tendency for masturbation. Why? Because being a psoric and a coward, if he is disappointed from some relations and he gets no to his proposals, then he becomes introvert and starts preferring masturbation instead of relations. Because masturbation is always successful, being with yourself, and you don't have to deal with the other person and be successful. You don't have any problem with your image. And many times, Lycobodium, there is sometimes a tendency to become a gay because he is very coward to these things. He may have some disappointments with girls. He is very intellectual and romantic and sensitive. He has that tendency for art, and thus it is easier to find this sensitiveness to a guy, another psoric guy, and become a gay, a homosexual. Yet he is going to become a psoric homosexual, a psoric gay. Shy, doesn't want to reveal these things to others, and so on. He will not be the psychotic gay that says, I'm a gay and I'm proud of it. I want to fuck you. Okay? I tried to give you some pictures. You will read all these things in details in the classical miasmatic constitutional homeopathic materia medica. Volume 2. So, he has a great lust in the intellectual field for sex, but he's not much of a sex guy when it comes to action. He's not so strong sexually to be able to have one orgasm after another, to be able to please one woman many times or two women at the same time. He has the desire, great desire, many thoughts, many scenarios in his mind, much of desire, but in action he is not so effective, not so strong. What about relations and family? Again, being the psoric person, most of the times he is manipulated by syphilitic persons. And if the syphilitic person is smart, he will let him believe that they have an equality in a relation, but she will have the upper hand. She will be the dominant person. So we have talked about his psoric characteristics, his intellectuality, his cowardness and shyness, and a great field about sex, family and relations. Cowardness. This has to do also with irritability. Most of the times he's not such an irritable person. Being cultivated and being civilized and being intellectual, he tries to talk with others about things, to negotiate, to calm things. He gets angry if others doesn't recognize and doesn't accept him as a civilized and cultivated person, as a kind person. When others are more civilized and more cultivated than him, he may be disturbed, but he is not a dynamic person anyway. When others speak rude and are very psychotic towards him, and they try to make him do things, but he gets angry, not so much, but he doesn't express his anger easily. Or he may talk with arguments, try to discuss it, to find solutions. He doesn't like fights. Even if he is stronger physically from the other guy, again, he doesn't like fights. Fears. Doesn't have any great fears. mostly introvert, but not so much introversion. These are his main characteristics, his main psychological characteristics. This is his essence, and this is the psychological profile. So, being such a guy, he tends to become a teacher, a researcher, a writer of books or of plays, theatrical plays, movies, cultured ones. That's his field of expertise, and he's a very good teacher or researcher. He isn't a good businessman. He doesn't prefer risky professions or risky hobbies. He doesn't like so much dancing, he prefers talking. If he has learned, he has gone to a school and is good at dancing, he will also prefer dancing. Now, let's go on. We have seen the essence and the psychological profile. Let's go to the body type. And his, let's go first to the non-verbal data. He will call you to set an appointment. He will be gentle, kind, intellectual, sophisticated talking, sophisticated words and phrases. He asks things. Even from the telephone, I've got this. He has gone to other doctors, they told him that you have this diagnosis of disease. He goes and reads medical books, he goes to the Google and Googles it and reads scientific material about his disease, everything about his disease, and he comes to you at the office determined to ask and learn and specify all things. He is also a bit mistrustful. Being intellectual and reading and knowing things, he is mistrustful. But if you persuade him with arguments, then he is okay. But he wants to satisfy his mind. He wants to know the mode of operation. He comes to you and he asks you, what's homeopathy, doctor? He has already written many things about homeopathy, but he wants you to tell him, how does homeopathy act? What are the homeopathic remedies? How do they act? What's their action, the mode of operation? Do they have any side effects? How do they act? Have you treated other persons with such a disease? What are the percentages of cure? What studies can you refer me to? How much bibliography is there for this? Is it scientific? And so on. Can you refer me to studies about it? Research? Scientific studies. If you convince him, then it's okay. He relaxes. But he is mistrustful and intellectual. So, he is gentle, he is intellectual, he is sophisticated, he comes to the appointment. He doesn't wear extreme clothing, he doesn't have an extreme appearance. He has the image of the cultivated, clean a guy with a suit or with the sport clothing, but clean and tidy, and but not very much tidy like Nux Vomica. And he asks questions and he's the good boy, the good student, the good professional, the civilized man in discussion. Other non-verbal data. Some in the books it's described that Lycopodium has the body type, the pear-shaped body type like Natromoriaticum. That is, he has a wide area here, wide hips, slender legs, slender trunk, slender neck and arms. But from my opinion and point of view and clinical experience, it's not so often that we have this type. We may have it in women, not so in men. Mostly we have the psoric body, that is either short or tall, but with a narrow body structure, not so strong and wide bones, not so strong, but has endurance, doesn't have much strength, is not so quick, but he has endurance. The yin body type. Let's go to the physical characteristics. Now, first, let's go to the mind rubrics from Kent Repertory. When we group together the mental rubrics from the repertory of Kent about Lycopodium, we come across a great team, a great group with many rubrics and characteristic rubrics that confirm what I have also already told you, that he is a psoric and coward intellectual individual. For example, we have timidity, indecision. Lycopodium is very indecisive because he has many thoughts, many arguments in his mind, and he starts saying, should I do this? What are the things that are in favor of this? What are the things that are not in favor of things? And starts thinking and analyzing and postpones to take a decision and act. He's intellectual. Indecision. Fear of appearing in public, but goes through with ease and comfort. You may have a lecturer, and even if he knows the subject he's going to lecture about very well, and even if he teaches for years, because he is a coward and is afraid of his image, the first some minutes before, he gets anxious. And when he starts, for one or two couple minutes, he is anxious and he has this stage fright. But very easily and very quickly, he gets well and he is not relaxed and teaching and never stopping lecturing, but he does well and he's a very good teacher. But in the beginning, he has this anxiety. You must compare this with silica, a silica individual and an argentum nitrico individual and a valeriana individual. We will talk about it later, but let me give you an example. The silica individual has this fear that he will not manage to do well when he lectures to others, or when she is examined orally, and she doesn't get well. She's afraid, she tries to avoid lecturing, and when she does lecture, she has this great anxiety and she doesn't perform well most of the time. Argentum nitricum, being an obsessive guy, has this anxiety, great anxiety, for long before an event, before a lecture, before an important meeting. He gets very anxious before, on the process of waiting for the event, and he may have a nervous diarrhea or a nervous frequent urination. But when he starts lecturing, when the event is on and going, he is okay then. A valeriana has this anxiety to perform well, and before the event has these stomach ailments and restlessness, and during the event she's better, but many times after the event she gets well if she performs well. Other psoriatic rubrics: mildness, timidity, cowardice, irresolution, anxiety, fear, and so on, sadness, weeping. So, one main group of the most important group of symptoms, of mental symptoms, is that he is psoriatic and coward. Then we have another group of symptoms, important one, that he is haughty and critical, being, but this is a psoriatic haughtiness, a psoriatic vein. He is an intellectual guy, he has an idea about himself. What kind of idea? He is haughty, one or two. Haughty, one or two, the most. While sulfur is haughty two, platina is haughty three. Lycopodium is haughty one or two, because he has read a lot, he has discussed a lot, he has thought a lot, and so in some fields he knows that he is a very effective intellectual guy and a very cultivated person, and that's why he has this self-confidence. But if you ask him, are you smart? He will tell, okay, normal, or a little more smart than others of the average. Because he has this shyness, and he has this psoriatic image, and he doesn't want you to believe that he is very hot, very haughty and vain. And critical. Lycopodium is critical only when he comes. That is, He will not be critical towards his boss. He will not express, because he's coward, I'm sorry. But he will be critical towards his wife if he is much older than her, much richer than her, with a profession that is better than her. If he who is a doctor of 35 and he gets married with a young girl of 18 that has just graduated and has not gone to the university and doesn't know much, then he will be critical in the sense that he believes that he knows and he wants to guide things. We will do this in this way. We will do that in that way. I know things about, many things about this. But he will not be provocative. He will not be syphilitically or psychotically critical. He wants to be, he wants his wife and his students to be fond of him, to appreciate him, to have a cultured esteem. Being so intellectual, it's easy to have a disorder of his intellectual functions, becoming tired easily and having memory problems if he's overworking intellectually. Let's go now to the general physical characteristics, the physical rubrics of Lycobodium. See the main points. He is, wears cold, wears in, wears wind. Yet sometimes he can be also wears heat as it comes to head and spine. So he is cold in general, but congestive, hot head and spine. He is worse afternoon, especially 4 to 8 p.m., and worse in the evening. He is better motion, especially in rheumatic pains, but worse at the beginning of motion, and worse from exertion that heats him up. He is worse pressure and touch. He is worse eating because he has a psoric digestion. He is hungry. He wants to eat a lot. He eats very quickly, even if he has time. He eats very quickly and hurry, and if he eats a lot, and especially at night, late at night, he has a poor digestion and he has problems. He has gases, he is a flatulent person, especially with beans and peas and with onions. He is also troubled from milk. Milk, oysters and shells, and onion, and beans and pigs make him flatulent. He wakes up at night and goes for one or two times for urination without having any prostate problems. Lycobodium has many troubles with his liver and his stomach. He has also early ejaculation and loose erection. Night polyuria, eruption problems, That's the things about Lycobodium. And let's see now the Lycobodium individual in the acute illnesses. Lycobodium, as I have told you, he has a weak digestive system. So we can find a characteristic picture and strong picture of Lycobodium in pain stomach, diarrhea, and also pain bladder and pain kidney. And some eruptions. Mostly problems with the digestive system. I started the description with the essence and the miasmatic profile, and then we have gone to the psychological profile, the nonverbal data, the the mental rubrics, the physical rubrics and general characteristics, and in its application in acute illnesses.